Are you all right, Jude?
Yeah, I'm fine. Just a bit whacked, that's all.
You don't look too good.
It's the blood pressure, Cass. I'd be all right if I could fall asleep.
Jeez, it's not dangerous or nothing, is it? I mean, can't I do something?
Yeah, go to sleep, will you?
No way. Hey, Phyllis.
What?
Jude's crook.
So?
So do something.
Oh, forget it. Too busy worrying about herself, and let's face it, you have plenty to worry about.
Who's worrying? We're still free, aren't we?
Really? Well, what are we going to do? We're going to hole up in here for the rest of our lives? I bet the cops are moving in right now.
I'm warning you!
Yeah, Jude, look, why don't you try to get a bit of kip, eh? Give the old blood pressure a rest.
Okay. Sweet dreams, Phyllis.
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Just thought you'd like to know that they're all settled down, Governor.
Thank you. And Solitary?
Oh, can't shut Mitchell up. She's been singing her head off ever since the police left. Any news of the others?
No, not yet.
Are you all right, Governor? You look very tired.
Yes, I am a bit. It's been a long day.
Well, there's no point to it, is there? And they're all going to finish up back here sooner or later.
How's Stevens getting on? Has she settled down yet?
Oh, more or less. I don't think that sharing with Desmond's going to do much for her, though.
Oh, why not?
Well, let's look at the facts. Desmond's just committed murder. That's hardly a settling influence on someone like Stevens.
I wouldn't worry about her if I were you. Mara's a very level-headed person.
Level-headed? Governor, I don't want to state the obvious, but I mean, her husband...
I really don't want to talk about it at the moment. The decision's been made, and I happen to think it's the right one.
Yes, of course.
Sorry. I must be more tired than I thought.
Look, why don't you go home, Governor? I'm doing a double shift. I can call you if there's any news.
Yes. Yes, all right, I think I will. Thank you.
Hi.
Hello, love. I wasn't sure if you'd still be up or not.
Oh, nearly was it. How come you're so late?
Well, Cassidy made us clean up the hall when we'd finished.
Oh, fair enough.
Like hell. We didn't dirty it. It was the basketball team. Mm. I'll be having something to say at the next committee meeting, don't you worry. How's Joey?
Oh, no, Bess, don't. I just got him settled.
You look, a bit worn out, love. Has Joey been giving you a bad time?
Oh, no, Well, he's just been a bit grizzly, that's all. I never thought he'd go to sleep.
Hey, Sarah, you haven't got visitors, have you?
Yes, it's Barry. Sorry, Jude. Didn't mean to wake you up. I've just closed the door.
No, you don't. You told me so much about him, I wouldn't mind seeing him. G'day, Barry. I'm Judith.
Hi.
Oh, real surprise, eh, Baz? Jude landed on my doorstep this afternoon. Didn't even tell me she was coming.
Oh, yeah? Where are you from, Jude?
Adelaide. Sorry about the face. It's my beauty treatment. I have to wear it every night for an hour before I go to bed.
Some of the things you women get up to, eh?
Yeah. Well, I could go a cuppa. How about you two?
Yeah.
What the hell's the matter with him?
It's just next door's dog. He's always waking Joey up.
Yeah, they never take the poor thing for a walk. He's just bored. He'll stop in a minute.
Yeah, well, good watchdog, I suppose. Good, and how you fit it all in, Barry? 9 to 5 selling insurance. Tuesday, Thursday night, you got the accountancy course. Oh, and Wednesday, Friday, choir practice. When do you two get together?
And you've forgotten Saturday afternoon.
Oh, yeah? What happens then?
Barry's scoutmaster for the local group.
Yeah, we've bought little Joey his first cub uniform already, haven't we, love?
Gosh, cubs, eh? Lucky kid.
That clock's not right, is it, love?
Oh, I think so. Why?
Oh, Battersby's called a sales conference for 8 o'clock in the morning. I better get a move on or Mum will think I've left home.
Righto, love.
It was nice meeting you, Barry. Take it easy on the way home, eh?
Yeah, actually, that's pretty good advice. The police seem to be everywhere tonight. I suppose I'll be okay. I don't drink. Well, will we see you before you leave, Judith?
Yeah, minus the mask, eh?
Yes.
Oh.
Bye. Sorry. Right.
Oh, and he lives with his mum, too.
Oh, shut up, Reb. He loves Joey and I, and that's all that counts, so just shut up!
Cass, wake up. Wake up, Cass.
Well, don't be stupid, Brian. If they catch us, then I'll throw away the key.
Cass!
Hey,
Cass!
It's all right, Jack. I've got you. Forget it. Forget it. Oh, come on, Phyllis. She's crooked. She's a heart, a pacemaker or something. We've got to get help.
No!
We got her! Or do you want her to die, Phyllis? Well, do you?
Yeah, that feels better now, doesn't it? Now you wait here. Mum will get you a nice warm bottle.
Bloody rabbit food out there. You could have got some decent stuff in.
Wasn't expecting company.
Well, it's lumpy porridge, I suppose.
Oh, hell, Reb, look at the mess you're making. You could have done that in the kitchen.
What's the diff? Would have made the same mess. Anyway, I want to know who's coming before they get me.
Who is it?
Can't see anyone.
That stupid dog a bug at his own shadow. Look, you're going to leave after you've had your breakfast, aren't you?
No way. Plane doesn't leave till 4. Safer here than cooling my heels at the airport. I bet you're both belly aching.
Something at him if you like. That usually shuts him up.
Just shut the bloody kid up. Between the two of them, I'm going stark, stare and bulkus.
Yeah? Well, having you around doesn't do too much for my nerves either.
Hey, Phyllis. When you reckon we can go look for some tucker? Little Shirley is real hungry.
When I decide we're going.
I've seen the sun come up this morning. I can get us back to the bus real easy.
That's real clever of you, Parker. I suppose you think they're all sitting there waiting for us.
Oh, sorry, Phyllis, I suppose not.
Anyway, if you know where the bus is, you know which way north is. And that's the way we're heading.
Hey, that's straight into the bush. Jude will never handle that. She's whacked now.
It's too bloody bad. I'm not leaving anyone here to blab to the coppers. Gotta go and take a snakes. Anyone that puts their noses out that door will be breathing in gunpowder. I'll get lard belly up and ready to go before I get back.
Can I go home, please? I won't jump on you.
No, look, I know, love, I know. But you see, Phyllis there's real scared. It's better to do what she says. Makes her feel good. Come on, we'll wake Jude up, eh?
Oh, I'm awake.
Yeah, well, you hear what Phyllis said?
Yes. I always knew she had her brains in her bum.
Feel up to a hike through the bush?
I suppose okay, as long as we don't have to do any mountain climbing. What do you say, kid? You feel like a little walk in the bush beats sitting around here, huh?
Yeah, I'll probably be able to find us some tucker, too. I was real good at finding grub in the bush when I was a kid.
Come on, let's go. Well, come on!
G'day, Ferguson's electricians. The landlord sent me around. Something to do with the wiring and the laundry?
But I didn't call up about any problems.
Oh, I just do what I'm told to, Mrs. Through here, right?
Looks like the landlord's finally decided to fix up this dump a bit.
This place is busier than bloody Burke Street.
Well, nobody's stopping you from leaving.
Don't worry, I'm going. I'll need your car first, though. You can pick it up at the airport later.
Yeah, take it, just go. The sooner you leave us alone, the better.
God, you've changed, Sarah. Got the keys?
On the fridge.
G'day, Reb. You going somewhere?
Kevin, what are you doing here?
I've come to get me money, haven't I?
Yeah, well, you come to the wrong place. Don't reckon I'd be stupid enough to stash it here, do you?
Yeah. Now hand it over real nice like and no one will get hurt. But don't take too long about doing it, because my patience is worn real thin.
You didn't know what you were doing.
So we are. Oh, geez, I'm sorry, Phyllis. I could have sworn we was going north.
We're going nowhere now. We're in the kill the feather on our own.
Go, Cheryl. You rotten, bludger Phyllis. I tell you, you bloody lay off that little kid.
What the hell are you doing? You've been cut from everywhere.
Yeah, well, that's too bad, isn't it, Phyllis?
It's all right. I reckon we'll be going home real soon now. But we did pretty good, didn't we, Jude?